Hail, travelers.
Hello.
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 Howdy.
What's up, gamer?
Alrighty. Lots to go over today. Is everyone here, first off? Are we missing anybody?
Nope. There's all five of us.
Excellent.
We're all here.
You need to share your token, Takar. I can't access it. Okay, now I can.
Love your token.
Alrighty. Final preparations. Make sure everything is ship shape.
That means, like, apply all buffs and everything, make them marked down for you. That way you can see them.
Well, don't just put buffs on there because, you know, time passes and all that. So you won't get, like, maxed out blast and stuff like that. That you're going to have to decide here what you're going to cast first.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. Yeah. All right, cool. So
you get one spell.
One spell. Yep. What about food? Can we have taken food tokens?
Yeah. Well? Yeah, okay, that's fine.
Cool. So food tokens and a spell. What about potions? One action, effectively.
No.
Okay.
One potion just and two tokens.
Okay, cool. Works for me. Adjust y'all's our pre-buffs accordingly, guys.
Alright.
I think I'm gonna do the long straighter.
Well, I mean, I guess your spell doesn't have to be a spell. It's just one action of prep, I guess.
Okay.
It's more appropriate. Gotcha. So if you want to use a potion instead, then you can do that, but basically, you don't get to walk into the fight fully jacked and buffed out.
Makes sense.
How long do these summons last?
24 hours.
Okay. All right then. Okay then. Okay. Hit ready and map tools when you're ready to go.
I'm sorry I have to, but good old ready. Haha.
No, we can just turn action, first action, I want to attack Tarum.
I'm sorry.
Just kill Tarum immediately.
Yeah, we'll just get another bleeding one to replace it.
Tragic.
Starting isn't worth.
I forgot how funny Simeon looks on your token.
What? Why do I look funny?
My favorite part is mousing over Simeon's token and waiting for the load time.
Yeah, that's the best part.
This will take forever.
I mean, it's not as bad as it was during the Crystalline Towers.
Alrighty then. Before we get started, we're going to go ahead and do introductions. So we're going to introduce yourself and your character, a little bit about your character, and then we'll move on from there. Let's start here. Go ahead, Takar.
Hello, my name's Takar. I am a monk, cleric, ranger, rogue. I'm a pirate. I used to be the leader of the Freemen, but I gave that up to someone much younger than me. And that's I'm here to have fun with my friends and kill my grandfather.
All right. Tarum.
I am Tarum, Paladin of Glory, Ambassador of the Watchword.
one of the heroes who, well, I am the one who got stunlocked by the same gear. I have been with Watchwell for 7 years.
Okay. Zob.
Greetings. You look upon the Blessed of Babylon, the High Binder, the greatest goddamn cleric who ever lived. Indestructible Vanguard of Dalton.
Okay. Next is Simeon.
I am Simeon Stormraven of the Hikari, quartermaster of that esteemed faction. I am a cleric of life and of Inca, and I'm here to make sure that nobody dies.
Hadron.
I am Hadron Kell of the Hikari. I am a necromancer, and these are my bleeding ones.
All right. So be it. All right, gentlemen. Let me describe where you have arrived and how you got here a little. The dilating one is constantly shifting through the skies and through the just beyond the veil in the dream realm of Kalkatesh. Facing him is rather easy. One must simply follow the signs. The trail is large, and the creature is brazen and fears nothing. As you walk through the dream, using the guidance of the Silent Knights, eventually you are able to come upon the schism in time. And there, you walk through it. And here you stand in momentary suspension before a strange domain created by the creature's will, perhaps a remnant of its past. A building which appears to be more of an observatory than an arena, where the dilating one awaits you. All right. Five readies. So be it. I'm going to link some music to you guys.
Okay.
So that you can have spicy themes playing. You know what? I'm just going to do it in the Dilating One RP area, so I don't have to send you guys each other. I'll put it in the OOC. There you go. So that you can listen along. All right. And so, it begins. As you enter through a broken stone wall, all around you reality seems cracked and somewhat shattered. Clocks turn in ethereal, almost smoke-like fashion, moving in and out of existence, in and out of time and remembering. Ahead of you, the great observatory opens up into a nearly impossible building, with floating pieces of different eras mixing and mangling together. And there you walk upon the precipice, floating above a platform, precarious, sinister, wobbling beneath your feet. And there in the center, in a gaping wound in time, your enemy awaits you. All right, the time for mercy has passed. as you reach the precipice. The creature swirls its scythe around it, wrapping it in sands of time. Violet light emanates from each of its orifices. Its many eyes open and look towards you. It smiles. It has been some time since it last had a little fun. And so it begins your battle against the Dilating One. All right, gentlemen, rolling initiative. I'll handle it.
I'll take the 21.
In the rear with the gear.
Honestly, make a macro that just automatically does it with advantage.
Well, I my macro does it. Assuming your token set up correctly.
It didn't.
No, it did. It just didn't put the 21 on top.
Oh, okay. Okay.
All right. All righty.
Remember what? To edit in your damage to your macros.
Oh, yeah, because we got the plus four boom from...
Yes, for those of you that are unaware, Righteous Fury was chosen by the Living World, so that means that the heroes of Kalkatesh gain a plus four to damage rolls.
That's untyped damage.
It's additive to whatever damage that you do.
Okay, cool.
Do my bleeding ones gain a plus four?
They are not a hero of Kalkatesh.
It's a lich. They should have been cooler.
Should have made them out of heroes of Kalkatesh.
Yeah.
I mean, you can have one of them be a hero of Kalkatesh. I have the Skull of Sarmenti.
I will stagger it like that. Lad. That is unfortunate initiative.
Man, all you guys are so slow.
Alrighty.
Imagine having dexterity.
Okay, so, before we get things started, there's a couple of things that you get to know about. I need each of you to do me a favor and make a copy of your token and make it small. Okay. Clear it out. It doesn't need, like, any light sources or any states or anything. It's purely going to be a representation of something. So, during this battle, you will have something called an echo. This echo represents you from the past. So, except for this round, every round hereafter, your echo will go, movement-wise, to where you were last round, and it will linger there, and it will basically follow you in a one-round stagger. There are certain abilities and effects that affect these echoes, so be sure to pay attention on where they are. Any questions so far?
I'm good. Anybody else?
All right.
I'm good.
Good. Now we go over the traits. All right, the traits are hopeless, speaker, deadly, recovery, ruination, cunning, quickened tactician, grand clash, entropic, violet, greater combo, duality. Do you need me to go over those again?
I don't think so. It was entropic, violet, greater combo, duality. Was the last four?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, I got them all.
All right. I will explain those for you. Hopeless is the highest form of ruthless. It allows a bunch of different things to use entropy with, and they can also defeat faith checks. Speaker means this creature can speak, and it is a servant of the violet, which is means it can use power words. Deadly, it means it has front-loaded damage on its different attacks that are higher than the average of something its level. Recovery means it has a myriad of recovery abilities allowing it to heal or restore itself. Ruination. So this one is a little different. This represents that it is a creature that can debuff you, but the debuffs are not only combat relevant, but they are story relevant to the character. The most notable one that I should point out, this creature can aid you. I'll say that one more time. This creature can aid you. Keep that in mind. All right, next is Cunning, which you guys know what that does. Now we're going to talk about Quickened Tactician. So, it's the first time that Quickened Tactician has hit the board in Verum. Essentially, you will have 4 minutes to perform your turn. I will be using a stopwatch. I will warn you when you have 1 minute left. I will pause it when you ask questions of me, because you need certain things resolved or you're not sure about interactions. It will also be paused when I am explaining something. Do not attempt to use this to gain extra time. Doing so will result in an instant ending of your turn. If you run out of time, your turn ends. And if you lose actions or abilities based off of it, then that is your loss.
Is that 4 minutes per turn?
4 minutes per person.
Okay, cool.
Per person's turn.
Got it.
I was expecting only 30 seconds.
Nice. Now, the dilating one also has this limitation. I am allotted 10 minutes for the entirety of my turns. Alrighty. Let's see here. Alright. Also, if you pass your turn, can't go back, obviously. Alright, next up is Grand Clash. Now, what this means is that this creature is available for every single clash type. It has advantage on every single clash type. And the cost of failure, no matter the degree, is always violent death. I'll say that again.
Oof.
The cost of failure on a clash against this creature, regardless of the degree, is always violent death. Let's see here. Next one is Entropic. This creature has the ability to produce entropy on the battlefield through various abilities and whatnot. This entropy is considered war entropy and can be used in other fights and is added to the total. It can also use any entropy it generates during this fight as well. Violet, you guys know what that means. Greater combo. So this is the one of the highest forms of combo, although not the highest. I have abilities and effects that combo with off of each other, and that means that there are 5 layers possible. So pay close attention to interactions. And then finally, its last trait is duality. Everything that happens in this fight can affect the other fight because both of them are tied together. The most notable one is that if you damage this creature, it is damaged in the other fight, and vice versa.
All right.
Okay, those are its traits. Alrighty. Any questions?
I'm good. You guys good?
I'm good.
I'm good to go.
I'm good.
One moment, setting up my stopwatches. Normally I'd have a timekeeper do this, but I was not able to get anybody.
It's all good.
There we go. Move this over here so I can see it easier. And so it begins. Oh, my fucking phone keeps turning off. That's gonna be annoying. Okay. All right. Combat starts in 3, 2, 1. Alright, the dilating one will summons. Move these guys out of the way. Move to here. Let's see. AC. Scanning armor types. Bonus action. The dilating one will summon a strange ethereal sphere, spectral in nature, that pulses slightly. It will then raise its scythe and will attack. Simeon. First attack, 22 damage, waiting for responses.
No responses. Is this physical damage?
It is physical damage.
All right, DR4, so 18 damage applied.
Okay, second attack, 21 damage.
Lord have mercy.
Third attack, 21 damage. Constitution saving throw. This is versus a supernatural effect.
Excellent. And I'm in aura range. What is your bonus term?
+5.
Excellent. So this is not including that, so... ...26 total.
Okay. That'll succeed. Alrighty. That's it for me, preparing turn swap. Takar, go.
Cool. Bonus action, cast Hunter's Mark on the thing.
Okay.
Cool. Then I will move to here. And attack it twice. So that's one. I'm guessing a 16 does not hit.
It does not.
Cool. 24 to hit.
Does not hit.
Cool. Let's see. It's my two attacks. It's my bonus action.
My title is the first attack is an automatic critical hit.
Oh, my.
If it hits.
The first attack in combat.
If
it
hits.
Oh, it needs to hit for that? Okay.
Yeah, that's not an auto hit.
I mean, it just didn't specify.
It needs to hit.
Cool. Okay.
All right, and then that is my turn.
All right.
Deduct my one spell slot.
Tarnum. 1 second.
All right.
Swapping. Begin.
All right. Well, first, I will go ahead. Yeah, I'll go ahead and start off with drinking a potion of growth. Because it's using my actions, all allies within 15 feet gain 12 temp HP that stacks with other forms of temp HP. This includes the bleeding. And there are, everyone is within 15 feet, so everyone gets that additional 12. I will stay here.
Okay.
Drop in your bracket.
I have the wrong macro for healing. This. And then I shall do a martial check.
Okay.
Seventeen.
Insufficient.
All right. That will end my turn.
All right. I'm up. All of you. Wisdom saving throw.
Right. Is this a death effect or an effect that would impede movement?
This is a transmutation effect. Supernatural.
Cool.
17.
In the limited buffs we were allowed, we performed Hero's Feast last night. Would that be allowed or just the one?
That would have been something to tell me before we started. But that's fine.
I apologize.
I'll let it go. That's your only grace. If you forgot anything else, it's gone.
Thank you very much.
That's cool.
25.
That's an 18 for me.
Okay.
23.
27.
All right.
31.
Oh, I have plus two. No, I don't. I don't have bless up because I drink an invulnerability potion, not a heroism.
All right. Who got to 21? Who didn't get to 21, I should say. Excuse me.
Me.
State names. I don't know all your names.
Takar. Takar got
Takar?
18.
Okay. Are you the only one who failed?
I think so, yeah.
All right. The effect dissipates.
Cool.
All right. All right, I will attack Simeon.
A fan favorite, I see.
Your AC is 24, that's a miss.
Yes, sir.
Attack Simeon. Miss. Attack Simeon. Hit, 19 damage.
I think that 33 will hit.
Okay, that's that for that one. Stopping that one. One moment, please. Calculating. I'm going to be taking a lot of notes during this fight, so I will be pausing the time to take those notes.
Should I put my echo where I moved from?
Not yet. Start of round two.
Okay, got it.
At the beginning of each round, your echoes shift to where you were last round.
Okay.
And the reason that you make them small is that they can fill the same space as you, and that way you can still affect your token.
Gotcha.
That's done. All right, next turn, activating time. Simeon, strength saving throw.
And again, this is with the plus five. 17 total.
All right. Simeon, you are knocked prone and take 33 bludgeoning damage.
Oof.
All right, you are under the... I can't actually tell you that effect. So, because you didn't identify yet, but... All right, I'll just have to remember that. Pause time so I can note take this.
This is what you get for not drinking an invuln potion.
Rookie mistake.
Alright. Okay. Under the effect of. All right, Simeon, you feel as if something is pushing you down. I can describe no more than that at this time.
Ah, his spiritual pressure.
Sick. Alrighty. Scanning battlefield.
I believe I need to reapply this damage.
Starting time.
Yeah, there it goes.
Punish for weakness. Alright. Attack Simeon with advantage. /22 Waiting responses, Kate.
All good.
23 damage. Tick tock. All right. That's done with that. Next turn. Let's do this. All right, I will choose the invulnerability effect on Takar. I will use an ability. Takar, you're on round 3 of your invulnerability potion rather than round 1.
Got it.
In addition to that, let's see. You move 20 feet in this direction.
Oh, which direction? I'm sorry.
I moved you.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Oh,
my party.
All right. Charisma saving throw.
Is this an death effect or an effect that would impede movement?
No.
All right, guys. 18.
Okay. All right, let's see. I'm going to choose one of these for that. Let's choose... I haven't identified it, so I'm going to have to do this. Okay. Alright, sands begin to swirl around Takar, shifting and twisting around his form like serpents. Alright, that's it for them. Preparing to switch turns.
Zob.
Zobarok. Begin.
Okay. I move to there.
Okay. That will miss.
Unfortunate. Hit.
27 does hit.
Okay.
Damage.
Plus 9. Since it automatically crits. Assuming it is a aberration.
It is.
Okay, then it crits. For 9 more damage.
One moment, please. Always something I miss. There we go. There we go. There's my mob damage. All right, cool. What is that? How much is that? 29?
31.
31? 31? Okay.
I am going to action surge.
Hit.
Can you make me a wisdom saving throw, DC 15, against Grovel, since I hit you with my mace?
Sure. The wisdom, you said?
Yes. Okay. Unfortunate.
I don't think you can fail that, though.
He can on a 1.
Yeah, I don't think either.
Ones are always failures. So, ones are always failures.
Well, then I guess I will bonus action command Grovel. Because I use Taskmaster.
So you make, so I make the save again?
Yep.
Alright.
Except this time, it's at disadvantage, and it is DC 17.
Getting there.
Okay. 17, huh?
It's groveling now.
Alright. Make me a wisdom saving throw, Zob. Okay.
25.
Alright, let's see. I'm gonna go look at what grovel does.
On its next turn, it falls prone and takes no actions.
Oh. Okay, then. Alright, anything else?
That is everything I have. End turn.
Switching turns. Hadron.
I use my veteran title. Marshall, check this boy for medium success.
Okilly dokily. Pausing everything. Get ready. I'm about to hit you with fucking a lot.
I know.
And I'm just going to turn down the music here. Okay. So. Okay. Just tell me if you need me to slow down. All right. So this enemy has six different aspects and four initiatives. Aspects means that there are certain abilities that are tied to those abilities and to initiatives. They can only be used on those initiatives. Do you follow me so far?
I do.
Okay. All right. First up is combat. Dilation scythe. Dilate. Quicken. Slow. Stop. Time bomb. Next is its violet aspect. Epoch, which is E-P-O-C-H. Erasure. Fading Edge. Fool's Gambit. Rising Despair. The Herald Watches. Next is its Seconds initiative. And these abilities are Blurring Urgency. Hastening Heights. Reckless Speed. The Burden of Wisdom. The Metronome. The Price of Progress. Next is its Minutes initiative. Twisted Revelry. The Rat Race. Strip Away. Pulse Break. Correction. Bleed Out. Next is its Hours initiative. Toxic Dependency. Nova Wave. Mire of Time. Gravity Well. Grand Denial. Crushing Deadline. And then finally is Sands initiative. Sands of Folly. Sands of Madness. Sands of Regret. Sands of War. Sands of Time. Sandstorm.
All right, I think I got them all.
Coolio, choose one to identify. As an additional note, I should point out that even though you have seen its basic attack, there is a lot behind it. So that is a valuable one to identify, which is Dilation Scythe. Most people don't identify the basic attack, but I'm telling you, don't ignore it. But anyway, go ahead. Choose one.
Let's go with Dilation Scythe, then.
All right. Dilation Scythe. Click. All right. So as you can see, it says augmented by the following. That's because Dilation Scythe will continuously increase in power as the fight goes on. This means that there are certain effects and abilities that add additional, different modifiers and effects. The most notable thing is that the Dilating one can use its full attack action, which is three attacks of its scythe, on every single initiative it has, except for Sands.
Okay.
Do you follow what I mean by that? Alrighty then. In addition to that, the attack's damage is physical, but that might change due to augmentation. The weapon itself, for the purposes of anybody who's resistant to certain things, is considered a mithril. And This weapon is dispellable. While it is dispelled, it loses all augmentations for a temporary amount of time, and can even cause its attack bonus to drop. Clap. All right, there you go.
I think I'm going to dispel his magic scythe then, as my action.
Okay.
I'm going to do it at 5th level.
Okay, roll.
What do I need to roll?
D20 plus proficiency plus casting modifier. Insufficient.
Crap. Well,
do you have the advantage from food buff for
intro? I would have advantage if it's an intelligent.
Insufficient.
Crap. Then, bonus action, I'm going to have my bleeding ones move around Tarim and then shoot at him. Miss. There we go.
That 41 damage.
Yep.
1 minute warning.
And then, as my movement, I will move away. That's my turn.
Okay.
You
swapping turn.
Remember, I used Taskmaster, so everything has advantage.
Simeon, your turn.
Okay, first off, using veteran title. For a moderate success on Marshall.
Pausing. All right. What would you like to know?
Okay. Let's see. Let me bring up the note. Just a single, single one of the
choose one
subtypes. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's see here. Let's just start working our way through. I believe Dilate was the second one of the combat aspect.
Yes, sir. Dilate does this. I'll activate it for you. Select an effect. Reduce the round progression by D4, so that's backwards in time. If this effect is on an enemy, and this would reduce the number of rounds the effect has been on that creature to zero or less, the creature takes 5d6 psychic damage.
This is for buffs and the like.
That's for effects, period. So that means anything with a duration.
Ooh, all right. Okay, okay.
And that D10 is representative of the increment of time. So if it's like 8 hours, then that would be 4 hours.
Gotcha, gotcha. Okay, okay. All right, I will use half my movement to stand up from prone, unless something is keeping me down.
It is. Gotta make a strength saving throw. To stand up.
All right, I will do that for you.
As a note, the aura is fucked up because of growth, but you are inside of it.
Yeah, I was just about to say. So this is with the plus 5. 25.
Stand up.
Excellent. All right,
and the effect around you fades. Hold on, let me remove that. Continue.
All right, I will drink from a bandolier a potion of invulnerability. As my action.
Okay.
I will then... Let's see. Bonus action, I will second level healing word myself.
Okay.
Oh no. Apologies, just gonna delete something real quick. That is 14 plus my 3 from the Hakari bonus, so I heal for 70. And then, do I want to get out of its area?
You probably should.
Yeah.
It seems like it's targeting the person with the most max HP, by the way, in case you haven't figured it out.
My desires have left me vulnerable. I will move this 5 feet. Does this provoke an attack of opportunity?
Yes, it does.
Okay, so it has 5 foot range.
But...
or some version of Sentinel.
Hold on, I'm pausing since I'm thinking. I won't do that. I'll just attack you. Omega lol.
Hey. Then I will get... do I want to step farther back? I only have 50 move speed. Okay, 3 minutes so far. Yeah, I'll step back here with another 5 feet. And I believe that is it for me. Martial action, bonus action, move. And then for some reason it looks like I used a second slot, so I will just fix that, but round is over.
Alright.
There we go, good.
Start of my turn, resetting. Beginning.
Do you have something to make you not end your turn and grovel?
Yeah. I'm just deciding if I want to use it or not.
Okay.
It's not worth it. The dilating one has no shame and will fall to its singular knee, digging its scythe into the ground. Takar.
All right.
Remember, place your echoes now. It's the start of the round.
Oh, yes, yes. True, true.
And remember, it is where you were last round. So it would be where the combat started.
So is that.
Yeah.
So yeah, right there.
Takar will pat Zob on the back and say, good job, honey. And will step here. And attack the... dilating one. 28.
That'll hit.
For 35, 36, 42, 43, 44, 47 damage. And you know what? Make it DC 15 con save.
Oh, baby!
Fucking go.
One moment. One of the things disappeared off the board.
Oh.
I'm not sure why that disappeared, but... alright. Anyway. Hit for... how much did you say?
47 damage.
47?
Yeah, and that's a mixture of bludgeoning, necrotic lightning, cold, and thunder. If that any of those actually matter.
Alright, con save...
all right, guys, we got a chance. I like the odds on this one.
All right.
Keep going. Do it again.
I'll attack again. I think a 22 misses, sadly.
22 misses.
And then I'll bonus action punch it in the head. I think a 24 also misses.
That will miss, yeah.
Cool. And then Takar will stand there.
Okay. At the end of your turn, stop. Zabarak, make me a constitution saving throw. That is insufficient. Takar, make me a constitution saving throw.
This is a death effect or an effect that impede movement.
Negative.
Cool. Apply 20.
Insufficient. All right. Both of you take one level of exhaustion. Ignores resistances or immunities.
Cool.
All righty. Switching turns. Tarm.
All right. Here. I shall go ahead and Druid, I might as well try. I will bonus action just try to shove him. Wait, no, he's already on the ground. Never mind, I'll attack. Advantage because he's groveling. That I believe is a crit. So I'll go ahead and drop a second level Divine Smite. Added on top of that.
Total damage.
All right, the total damage is 24.
63.
64. 64
you
say? Is already built into the map. Yes, it is.
All right, I'll use my reaction. I will point at Simeon. Simeon, make me a dexterity saving throw.
Oh no, my one weakness.
You are within the aura. And you also gain 7 temp HP.
God bless. That is a 17. And let me do the 7.
That is insufficient.
17 total.
That is insufficient. The creature will raise up its scythe and will parry the blow and will use chronomancy to redirect its force into Simeon. Simeon, take the damage I would have taken.
Is that a spell? Oof.
That is not.
Okay.
What was your total damage?
Total of 64.
64.
Are you resistant to radiant?
I luckily have Invuln Potion from last round, so all right, cool. Yes. So that's 32. Easy.
Okay. Continue.
I attack again.
I'll miss.
Bless will not save that.
Mm-mm.
And then for now, I shall bonus action cast Shield of Faith on Sim.
Okay.
Bless you, sir.
And that will, I will like to use my veteran title to activate Marshall as well.
All right, choose one. 1 minute warning.
I would like to know Fool's Gambit.
Stopping while I explain. All right, Fool's Gambit under the... Okay, yeah, all right. Select an enemy. That enemy may heal to its maximum hit points. If they choose to do so, the dilating one gains an equal amount of that health as a damage bonus to his scythe attack. If that creature is stunned, paralyzed, confused, or in otherwise unable to concentrate or make mental choices, the creature automatically chooses to heal.
All right, fellas, I apologize just in advance.
Omega Law.
It's like an inverse Scar Seeker.
My thick, thick dwarf HP will kill us all.
Five feet up here. And then I will end my turn.
Alrighty. Transitioning. Starting.
This is why you save Warding Bond for later, Simeon.
Nah. It'll be fine.
Honestly, if Simeon dies, we get the better healer in Leon, so...
Wow, thanks.
Look, he does poison damage. Do you do poison damage? The answer's no. Also, guys, y'all are not going with what our plan for communication was, and it kind of hurts my feelings.
Dude, that's just too hard.
I'm not smart enough for that, I apologize.
I'm getting bullied right here. Excuse me.
Let's see if we move you for a second.
Oh, why did it appear under there? Oh, okay. That explains it. Alright. Why is that? Why is that not on the highest layer? That's so frustrating. Okay. Yeah.
For some reason, Simeon's just covers up every book.
Yeah, that's weird.
He's so thick.
So
anyway,
thick.
Anyway, I just remember that it's there.
It's all this con.
All right. Yeah. One, two.
No idea.
Got I can send myself to the back, and
it's fine. I know where it is. Dilating one will move like this.
Punch him, Torob.
Are we allowed to make attacks of opportunity?
Yeah. Miss.
Bless will not save that.
All right, Torob, bait out the one, and I'll roll the 20.
Push him down.
Yeah, I'm gonna attempt to shove him.
Okay.
Advantage, I'll roll this twice.
Alright.
I don't even need to roll, I can't fail that.
Can't fail 28?
No.
Because athletics is so high!
Alright. Anything else?
I'll save my reaction. I'm not gonna take.
Okay.
I can't believe you're leaving me to him.
No, it's coming for Simeon.
Okay.
It's coming for both of us. What are you talking about?
Pay attention, boys. One of you is about to die. Okay. Alright. I'll use layer action. I will target the effect that Simeon keeps covering up. I will pop it. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of them were used. That's... Alright, 15d6. Everybody within 30 feet takes 58 psychic damage. Or force damage, excuse me.
Whoa.
56 force, or 58 force?
58 force damage. Whoa. Okay.
Our attune is 29.
Just to clarify, does this count as a spell effect?
Yes.
Okay, then, those within my aura, have resistance.
I already have resistance.
If you do not already.
It almost got through my temp HP.
Okay.
Are any of my ones not in your aura?
This one is not.
Okay.
Is damage applied?
Not yet.
Okay. Damage applied.
There we go. So when I drop to zero instead, I'm going to activate this ability for my item.
Is that a triggered effect?
Yes.
Unfortunately.
When you would either be reduced to zero hit points and not killed outright or fail a death saving throw, I can choose to activate this, and I'm at one HP.
Hold on, need to think. This would all right. that would trigger at the same time, so I'll have to give you grace on that. All right, don't activate that yet because this happens at the same time as the other one. All right, so everybody applied damage from the first wave?
Yes.
All right, this effect also affects your echoes. Take that damage again.
Cool.
The echoes take the damage or we take the damage?
You take the damage your echoes take.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is this effect in a certain area? Like, can we see
it's around, a range it, of it? It's or... around this.
So it's 30 feet from that.
30 feet from that, which should catch everyone.
I'm going to borrow that. Only take half.
I take another 29.
Ouchie.
Okay. That wave of damage is off. Oakley dokley neighborinos. Then your effect goes off, Simeon. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm in it to win it, boys.
All right.
Guess what's going to attack you?
Oakley dokley.
Hey.
You're prone. Oakley. AC 26. Here we go. If you've got anything on the board that's ready to be used, I'd get ready to use it right now.
I'm not sure if it would be prone because it's a death ward like effect, so instead of dropping to zero, I go to one.
Explain.
I'm not sure though. In a death ward situation, you don't hit zero and go unconscious. You could go to one, and I have a clarification from the item creator that I go to one instead. So I don't know, would I fall prone in that case or.
Oh, that's a fair point. You'd be standing, so I wouldn't have advantage to hit you.
Excellent. That's all I got.
All right. Let's see if it can hold out. Also, please remember that if you're concentrating on effects, to roll your saves for them.
Yep. No concentration at the moment.
I need to roll on Hunter Smart. Bye-bye.
All right, Simeon. Here we go. Scythe raises up. Oh, hold on. I got a message.
Yeah. As part of this, trees appear.
If only this was Grandpa.
All right. Here we go. Dropping the scythe. Hit 19, first hit, downed.
Yes, sir.
Next, crit, next, VD. All right. Falcon, are you using it?
This Simeon guy really sucks.
All right. As the scythe befalls Simeon, moments before it would strike his body, there is a flash of green, and Simeon is impaled by the hand of Sylvanas. Simeon suffers green death.
What's that?
It means that Falcon kills you instead of the enemy. You could be resurrected.
I don't believe I can.
He's a Hikari.
You can be resurrected.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Because Black Pigs is gonna be mad this time.
All right. Unfortunately, that's the only time that Falcon can do that. Falcon is now on cooldown, and so is Koga. So you got no more cards to play. So as of right now, you are dead, but your soul remains intact. The armor does not claim it, as Green Death prevents that from happening. So you can be resurrected and revived as per normal. All right, and that's that turn next. Man, it's really bad fortune that you guys have, and I got the three initiatives in a row. All right. Dilating One will turn its gaze upon Hadron, and will attack him.
Bring it.
Bring it, I will. AC shield. Is 23. You shield. Okay. AC is 28. Attack him again. Hit. 22 damage.
I'm going to do my cold bleed for one thing. And blood offering. Take only 11. Well, take 11 minus the 4.
You got it. All right, is your damage where it is?
Yep.
Okay, third attack. Now we'll miss. Good. Good, 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 good. I will target Takara's invulnerability. Quicken that by 6.
Okay.
Which you're in round 3, round 9, so this is your last your last turn. In addition to that, let's see where you go. 1, 2, 20 feet.
I'm getting bullied.
Well, you move back. There we go.
Oh, never mind. I'm safe.
All right. Oh, boy. All right. For my next one, I will... I've got 2 minutes left. I will select. Hadron.
Good.
Constitution saving throw. All right, fail. Swirling sands appear around you. All right, Hadron, at the start of your next turn, you cannot move away from me and you must attack me, but you may attack me as you wish. Alrighty, that's it for that. Zob, your turn. Switching turns, one moment. Starting, go.
Move 20. I will cast Revivify.
Oh, Okay.
On Simeon.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay, I do that. Rise, Hikari. We no longer wear the same plate, but you are still one of my greatest allies.
You there, Simeon?
Yes, sir, I am.
Alright. Knock that death state off you.
Not dig, Pog.
This is certainly a feeling I never thought I'd feel.
Anything else, Zob?
We are going to marshal check.
Okay.
This is at disadvantage, I think, because of exhaustion, right? Or is that...
No.
Okay.
No, fine.
That is not good enough.
Insufficient.
That's my turn. Taskmaster ends, so you no longer have free advantage. End turn.
Switching turns. Hadron, start.
I have to attack him, so might as well start with that. That's a miss. Bonus action. I'm gonna have, my lovely bleeding ones come up, and actually I'll do three from back there and then two in the front, and they'll just attack. It's a myth. Ooh, so close.
It's 26 hit.
Only one that got closest, 26 for 26 damage.
Oh, 26 damage, okay.
26 is the AC, guys, we figured it out.
And then I call Marshall.
Insufficient.
That's me.
Simeon, start turn.
All right. I need to get a lot of HP in a hurry. First, I'll stand up, because I'm certainly prone this time.
Mm-hmm.
Who all is damaged? You're really not damaged that much.
Bro, please.
Oh, yeah. You're almost dead over there. Excellent. Okay, cool. Okay. Shout out to Eustace for this one. For my action, I'll be activating Moment of Joy. And because I'm still in the lines of the trees that erupted when I went down, but the Earth Refused to Die is still active, at least for the next minute. I will then Zob, you're damaged a little bit.
Missing 14.
I can do one. 5. I need a 6, but I can't heal any undead with this, sadly. Then I will 6th level mass healing word. One of them goes to waste, sadly. So Simeon, Zabarak, Hadron Kel, Takar, and Tarum all heal 65 HP. That is 68 for me because of Hikari. I then gain an additional 19 from Blessed Healer. And then I will Marshal. Arcadum, since I went down, are my buffs still active?
Yeah.
Food buff, etc. All right.
I don't think they fade. Well, so food, I have advantage on this. Food, I think, is faded, but...
Is it? Okay.
And vulnerability shouldn't. Stuff like that.
All right. Okay, so I just have normal roll on this. No, I have advantage because of our Hikari specialization.
Clap.
Easy game. 29.
All right, pausing. A 29 is sufficient. Not close enough for advice, though. Go ahead. What do you want to know?
I mean, time bomb might be good to learn.
Yeah?
Yeah. Time bomb, guys. Maybe. Maybe time bomb? I don't know.
Sounds very important.
Hit me with it, Arcane.
Okay. I figured you might. Alright, here we go, boys. This is what time bomb does. This bomb is placed within a square and a trigger round will be set. The bomb deals 1d6 plus 2d6 for every action used on the battlefield. The damage increases by 1d6 for every round that passes. Each time the dilate power is used, the time bomb's round counter increases by an equal amount to the amount dilated. This deals force damage to all enemies within 30 feet. This also affects echoes. In addition to that, I can use... whenever I use quicken... slow or stop on an effect, I can also choose to have it affect this ability. I know that's a lot. You guys need me to explain it to you?
Yeah, so damage increases for every round that passes, so...
So each round that passes, that's plus 1d6. But that also includes any times round pass forward. So that means whenever whenever I use quicken, that means time going forward, that means rounds are passing. So it counts that. It counts for every reaction used on the battlefield, which is plus 2d6. And in addition to that, the amount of time that it has until it goes off is determined by whenever I use the dilate power, whenever it is first set, which you didn't roll high enough to know what its initial set is. But you also know that anytime I use my time manipulation abilities, I can also use it on the time bomb.
Gotcha. So if you put on round 8, let's say, to trigger, dilate could push it closer to us and make it explode sooner.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Okay. Sounds awful. Thank you.
To be clear, though, there's some other things to know. It is a spell.
Okay.
It is considered a spell effect, and it is a magical effect.
So it could be dispellable.
Maybe.
All right.
If only there was spell that could dispel magical effects.
If only.
Find it first.
All right. Can I hide from this person? I'd like to take a step back.
I'm going to go to the bathroom real quick. I'll let you guys strategize. Pausing time for now.
All right. Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right. So, drafting new healers. If you're wanting to become the healer of our team, let us know.
Hey,
you did a good one.
He's not dead yet, all right?
Do we get that 3 whenever you pop it, by the way?
I mean, technically, he is dead. Died, but...
So, I just want to make a call. Warding Bond was not the choice?
No. I mean, it would have... I would have got bullied a little bit faster.
I mean, he didn't hit me, so nothing really happened.
Yeah, that's the problem. He went after me. Like a jerk.
Yeah.
Going after people with Dispel Magic, because that seems to be the main
that
thing.
That seems to be the gimme.
Is,
I think moving here is my best bet.
Yeah, because
he can't get to me.
Yeah, unless it has the ability
to
move.
He really wants to kill me.
Spaces.
I was going to Dimension Door your corpse out and then just use the rose on you.
Appreciate you, bud.
As a note, it's probably best to try to keep distance between you and your own echo. So that way
that's
you don't
true.
Get by things. Because a lot of it seems that, especially with the time bomb, there probably is some things that are good effects that can happen from the echo. But that being said, doubling damage taken on certain things can be kind of a deal. Yeah. So when people are moving around, just try to like rotate around things so you can try to create this. You and your echo.
Yeah, I'm only going to be 50 feet away right here, but I can't really move that far because I have to. I came up from prone.
If it's a 30 to get advice, I can hit a 30 on a 19.
I not hit a 30 on a natural 20, so I have a plus 2 to my martial.
I have a plus 11. That's the one thing I'm good at. Also, 26 AC, a little tough to hit.
Yeah, just
yeah,
a tiny.
Just a little, just a skosh.
I mean, I'm rolling with a plus 11 right now, plus 12. I think I'm rolling with a plus 11.
I need to roll an 11 in order to hit it.
Yeah.
I'm rolling with a plus 11.
I have advantage.
We need to spread out is the main kind of thing about the fight.
Yeah. But he's coming after me. He's bullying me.
It's hilarious.
Because I can't shove him, I'm probably going to be saving my reaction for the taking hits sort of thing. I can only take, I think, the wording is only one attack, so realistically it's not all that.
It can't fail a 28 athletics check. Meaning, that Chrono, if you're watching this, ha ha ha, you can't grapple it.
Yeah.
you say that, but idiot. I feel like Chrono is the only one who stands it.
Maybe.
I think it is possible for
if
that
they
one
can get
yet.
Hex off, potentially.
They would need Hex, and then they would also need, what is it?
I think we also should probably, if we can get Hadron away, if you can, if you don't have to forcibly attack him again, which he'll probably keep bullying you with that for a good amount of time.
Oh yeah, he's definitely going to keep forcing me to attack him.
If you can get away, dispelling his thing might be the way to go.
He's going to keep forcing me to attack him so I can't cast Dispel Magic, but, that's why it hits the means.
So it only has a, what was its con save again? Plus 7?
Seven.
So I have a, you know, an okay chance of potentially stunning it.
You can stun it, that changes the fucking game,
well,
bro.
No, if I can stun it, the problem is though it'll still get two turns after my turn.
Two turns. The stun ends on your round, not its.
Oh yeah! Guys, I'm level 12 and
doesn't
I
don't know
how
to play.
That's actually not how it works in multi-initiative fights.
Oh, it doesn't?
Yeah, one initiative, I would imagine.
Okay. Because
one stun only cost me one initiative, not my entire turn.
Yeah, yeah, it's like four monsters, effectively.
Boo.
All right, I
also,
think I'm
back.
Move 5 feet, Mac. Welcome back. I will move back here, and do I get smacked for it?
Hold on. One moment, please.
No rush.
I realized I haven't eaten yet today.
Oh.
I feel that.
Keep yourself healthy, dude.
I stayed up all night working on this fight, and then I ran today, and I haven't eaten yet. So I'm going to order food real quick.
That's fine.
Yourself some food.
Also, while you're at it, you know, just shave some HP off the boss just to, you know, be a pal and take some. That way you
get
some more time to yourself. Yeah.
It's already decided. Come on.
Man. That's a weird way to say the words, please don't kill us.
Well, no, look, I'm not saying don't kill us. In fact, like I said, I'm here to kill my grandfather, who you're currently beating up on. Not Simeon, but Hadron. So if you can keep doing that, and we've already baited out our free, like, die but not die, I mean, it's perfect. Just kill Hadron. I'll pay the guy, like, 200,000 gold and a bunch of cool stuff. And just leave, and then I'll live a happy life.
Wow,
you say that, but like, then the world blows up.
Well, the problem is that if we win this fight, I have to go back with Hadron, and I've already made a deal that he can kill me. So I lose if I win.
But here's the thing: is what if he dies, but we win? You don't have to walk away.
True.
I'll take him down with me.
Anyway. Yeah. Okay, I'm good now. Starting your turn up in 3, 2, 1, go. Time started.
Yeah, just moving 5 feet left, that's all I have. Do I provoke an attack of opportunity?
You sure do. Hit me with it. But I'm not going to use it.
Uh-oh.
Oh, kindness?
Well, it's dirty sight.
It isn't.
That's it.
Editor's note.
That's it for me.
Editor's note. It wasn't kindness. All right, let's see here. Hold on. End of turn. Oh, I will instead use my reaction to do this.
Don't hurt Mini Takar.
Yeah. I will target Simeon. Simeon, make me a charisma saving throw.
I'm starting to think you don't like me.
It's not personal.
I know.
This charismatic dwarves.
Charisma is actually a thing I'm proficient in, so this is plus five.
What the fuck?
All right, good shit.
Easy!
That was a very good one to make.
31.
All right, start of turn, calibrating, stern turn, start, actions refreshed.
Our little boys move.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Change all echoes to appropriate positions. All right. One, two, three, four, and I will choose you. So I need all of these creatures and yourself to make a charisma saving throw. You roll at disadvantage, Hadron.
All right.
All of them are in my aura. Except for...
DC of 21.
Hey. Two fail, one pass. Just give me a second for mine. I can't make it, but let's do it anyway.
20 always makes.
I can't make it.
Alright. Okay. You hear the sound of a soft clicking like a clock back and forth, back and forth, and a strange shimmering effect comes over these creatures here. Okay.
Fred actually made it.
Of course, Fred would.
Which one?
Fred.
Fred.
Oh, okay then.
That's the only one that has a name.
It's cool like that.
All right. There, that'll do for that. Okay. Move there. Provoking.
Doesn't take it.
Okay. Excellent. This pleases me. All right, I will choose Bless. We'll quicken that. Okay, why one round? Who here is affected by Bless?
I am.
I am for an hour.
Oh, yours is in an hour increment?
Mine
it's
is
a potion of heroism.
Oh, I selected Bless, not heroism.
Okay.
Who's actually affected by Bless?
I don't think anyone.
Yeah, everyone who has the Bless effect got it from a potion of heroism.
Uh-huh. All right, then. Let me roll an Arcana to see if I can change that up. Eh, not good enough. All right. Okay. In that case... Well, that changes things. Yes.
Right there, boys. Takar, you're switching over to turn. Resetting starting time.
All right, team, I got a question for y'all. Do we pull Operation Bling Bling or no?
No.
It literally doesn't do anything.
We'll pull Operation Bling Bling before this fight is over.
I don't even know what it is. No one filled me in on this.
Don't worry, it doesn't
have money at it until it goes away.
No, it's not money.
I would like to bribe the enemy of all creation.
Do I get in the way of Fred and his work? Yeah, well.
And you're in the way.
I'll move 25 feet to here.
Okay.
I will smack it with my mace. And miss. I'll smack it with my mace again. And miss. I will then martial check. Because I haven't been doing that.
Okay.
My team probably is mad at me for not doing that.
Okay.
I have advantage. So roll it twice. 28.
That is sufficient. What would you like to know?
I want to learn about the metronome.
Okay, metronome does this. Choose enemies within 15 feet up to 5. They must succeed on a DC 21 wisdom or charisma saving throw. If they fail, they are under the effect of the metronome. While under the effect of the metronome, anytime one of those creatures attacks, all other creatures in the metronome take 5 psychic damage.
Interesting. I feel like it affects me.
Man, I think I know what happened to y'all. Cool. I will then spend a key point to bonus action disengage and then use my remaining 20 movement to get to here.
All right. That it for you?
That is it for me.
Okay.
Thank you for your time.
Stopping turn. Tarm, resetting. Start turn.
All right. Question. How does grappling and moving other players interact action-wise? Is one of your attacks, because grappling is a modified attack, or does it use the entire action?
Grappling is a modified attack. However, once you grapple them, you won't be able to use your weapon if it's two-handed. Mm-hmm. You can move them and drag them around as per normal rules, half movement and all that.
I shall move up here. And then I'd actually like to grapple... Hadrian, you want to be out of right next to him?
I mean, it would be nice.
Yeah, all right. I will grapple Hadrian, and I flip him around.
Well, roll.
Okay. And I have advantage, so... Oh, I have the wrong person selected. First name.
I'm grappling you. We're hugging.
Well, I have a plus 9, so that's 12 and the 14, so 20.
All right, you can move him.
All right, I will flip you around me real quick. So you're no longer next to him. Step in. Oracle. And I will use my other attack. 26 hits, correct?
Yep.
Cool. Four damage, I believe. And then all allies in 15 feet gain 10 temp HP.
Does that have a duration?
One round.
Okay.
It does stack with other forms of HP. All right. That is my action movement. And then I'd like to make a martial check. Try.
Okay.
Insufficient. I believe that will end my turn.
All right. Ending turn. And that's to all allies, correct? Within 10 feet? That temp
within
HP?
15.
Within how much?
15 feet.
All right. Hold on. I'm curious. Is that a may or must effect?
Let me check.
I think it's time to double check that.
The pulse. Whenever you use your action for any reason, you and allies within 15 feet of you gain 2d4 temporary hit that lasts until the start of your next temporary hit points gained from this ability stacked with other sources of the temporary.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that answered my question. That is unfortunate. I will select that effect. I will use Dilate. Everybody takes 15 psychic damage and loses that temp HP.
Ouchie.
So it effectively deals 25?
Yeah.
Okay. Question, does that count as a spell effect?
No.
Okay.
Alright. It's time I stop playing nice, though. Go up here. Provoking.
No.
Okay. I will select Tarnum. Tarnum, please list out how many positive beneficial effects that you have active on your character at this time.
Any activatable or things like resistances from items count as well?
That's auras, that's spells, things like that.
All right. So, I have the aura, all the auras from the Paladin.
Yeah.
As well as I have... The,
list
the,
them out. Take your time and list them out.
I'll just grab a note, write it all down.
Yeah. And while that's okay, take your time, because I can use another action and resolve that. All right, I'll do that on you, and then I will turn and select. Okay, we're gonna do that. Yep. All right. I will select. Hadron.
Yes, sir.
Make me a strength saving throw.
No. That one's pretty good.
21.
You are technically in the aura if it helps for anything.
Yeah.
You might not be, because I did this ability after that. You got that list for me?
I am still working.
All right. I'm going to pause the time while you do that.
Hey, guys, you might be using strip away.
Did you commission this music?
I was made by a fan that heard me talk about the Dilating One. It's sick, isn't it? It's Tres
yeah,
Noir.
It's really good.
I like it.
Yeah, it's got that good ambience.
Yeah, Tres Noir made it. He made this version for the past, and then Scott Jund made a version based off this for the present fight.
That's pretty sick.
Yeah. Nice.
It's very sick.
And this includes racials as well?
No.
Okay.
Racials are fine. Specifically magic effects.
Magic.
Yeah.
All right. Active and then thing. Forgot that. Potion. I will paste them in chat. I believe this would be... Wait. Wow, that did not format at all.
Just send it to me in a DM.
Oh, all right. And then I have it separated by what they are from as well.
All right. Resolving effects. Time is still paused. Okay. All right, so each of these I'm going to try and take off of you or suppress them for 1 minute if they are a natural or constant effect. You can choose to protect one, but for each one you protect, I will heal an amount of hit points, and that amount will increase for each one you protect. So if you protect just one, that's the minimum amount of healing. If you protect two or three or four, then that gets multiplicative. So... Hero's Feast. Would you like to protect it?
No.
All right. Let me start listing these out. All right. Orb of Protection.
That is the one I would like to save.
Okay. Orb of Courage.
No.
Orb of Warding.
Nope.
Let's see. Your attributes from armor.
I'll unfortunately give those up.
Attributes from shield.
I will unfortunately give those up.
Potion of heroism.
I will give that up.
Potion of growth.
I will give that up.
All right, debuff down. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 on that. All right.
And you said this is suppressed for 1 minute, correct?
If it is a natural effect from an item or from your aura, it is suppressed for 1 minute or until round 13.
All right. And if it has a timer on it, it is just straight up.
Say again?
If it has a timer, such as Potion of Growth was 1d4 hours, which I got a 2 on, and Heroism is 1 hour.
Oh, okay, those aren't natural effects. Those are just gone.
Okay, yep, I figured.
Constant effects are the ones that are suppressed instead.
All right.
All righty. Round 13. Strip away. All right. For each spell that I strip away, I will conjure its energy, and now I will attempt to turn it into entropy. All right, let's see if I can do that. E100. Let's see, with eight effects, give me... Nope. And... Nope. Nope. Yes. One entropy. Okay. Coolio. That'll work for me. Alright, now, Hadron effect goes off. You chose to keep that aura. He makes the save. Coolio. Alright. Time started. Next round.
The aura is now down to a plus 3.
Alright, 20 would have made it anyway. Alright, here we go. Hours. Alright, that selected area. You will see strange colors start to emit down from the bottom of the floor. Time begins to shift and change as you are pulled towards the center. Everybody within that area needs to make me a strength saving throw. The DC of this is 20. Let me know who makes it.
I made it.
If you made the save, you may spend a reaction to leave that area. Would you like to?
It does get benefits from us using a reaction, so remember that.
Mm-hmm.
As a note, anyone who leaves increases the damage of the spin bomb here, and that is probably going to go off.
Mm-hmm. Do we know the timer for that?
Nope. You do not. Nope. You're not roll high enough yet.
Gotcha.
Decisions.
I did not leave.
Oh, okay. I was waiting to hear that. All right.
My character didn't move. Sorry.
Okay, then. Nobody leaves. All right. All right. At the start of the next hour's initiative, this area will take a massive amount of damage, and those of you that failed cannot move. However, this effect can be dispelled.
And this is a separate effect from the time bomb?
Yes.
Okay.
In 1 hour's time?
No. Next round. At the beginning of the next hour's initiative. So my initiatives have names. Seconds, minutes, hours, hands. Okay. At the beginning of the next hour's initiative. Follow me so far?
Yes.
Okay. And we're going to do that. I'll save that. Okay. Sans time. All right, I will select Zob.
Hey.
All right, make me a Constitution saving throw.
I'm going to reroll that using my food token.
Okay. Insufficient. All right. All right, swirling sands start to appear around you, Zob.
Okay.
And that'll work.
All right, switching turns over. Turn start. Go.
Wait, can you grapple and move Simeon out?
He cannot move at all.
Oh, okay. Simeon can't move at all.
I can't move him.
Got it.
And Zob cannot move at all.
I passed the strength save, though.
Yes, but you chose to stay.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Lock in effect.
Do you have any dispel?
I can't hit it. It's not a physical thing that I can hit.
He said it was a color coming from the ground. You could potentially hit the ground and try to break it. It's a thought.
Okay.
It's better than nothing.
I specifically said that nobody can move out of it.
I'll use one of my charges of the spelling chat room. Card.
In addition to that, they haven't identified it yet, so I don't have to be very clarified on the rules because they haven't identified it. Go ahead.
Do I need to roll to hit the ground?
Oh, you're trying to use a weapon attack to dispel it?
Yes.
You do have to roll to hit the ground, AC 5.
Nice.
You didn't fuck up. All right.
Okay.
What's the dispel type on that? Is it just a dispel magic? Does it have a level?
It's a level 3 dispel magic.
Okay, roll for it. Insufficient.
Bless
doesn't affect that.
I don't think bless helps.
Oh yeah, it's a check, not a... Never mind, save.
You know what? I'm gonna carouse that.
There you go.
You're gonna what now?
Carousing.
Alright then.
Use carousing?
Yeah, go ahead.
That's your one.
And... Oh, there we go!
Okay.
That'll work. Okay, effect fades.
Me trying to move and being unable to, does that consume my movement?
No.
Okay. Then I'm going to move over here and give the boss a martial check.
Okay. What do you want to know? Pausing time.
Might I suggest Sandstorm? Because he's been putting sand on a lot of us.
Yeah, let's find out more about being covered in sand that looks kind of like snakes or dragons.
All right, Sandstorm. For each enemy that is affected by one of the many sands, they all must make rolls against the sands that each other possesses and is affected by uniquely. If they fail, they are all affected by these. In addition, for each failed save, the dilating one may make an attack against an enemy in range.
That is good to know, everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Now to figure out if we can, how to get rid of the sands.
Probably with spell magic.
Or attacking the sand.
Work for the ground.
Yeah. Consume the
sand. Action, eat sand.
Okay, I will... Bonus action, healing word, Simeon.
Appreciate you.
Nine plus whatever bonuses you get.
Hikari's 3.
And that'll be my turn.
Okay. Hadron, turn start.
I'm going to cast Dispel Magic at third level on the time bomb.
All right.
I'm guessing I'm going to have to roll for that.
Yep. That is sufficient.
Nice. Bonus action, I will tell my boys to spread out and have the two that aren't affected by metronome attack. Shit. I will end my turn.
All right, at the end of your turn, I need you to make me a wisdom saving throw. All right, you're good.
That's something I can do.
Alright. The sands fade around you, Hadron.
Excellent.
Okay. Just a heads up, Simeon. You are at negative 1250 DKP for healing multiple people that aren't me.
Oh, son of a bitch.
Yeah, sorry.
Did you? I gave you a gift. Did you take that off?
Yeah, but I also counted that you did die.
That's true.
Yeah.
All right. Did you say your turn was done there?
Yes, I did.
Simeon, start turn.
First off, let's get a marshal off. Nineteen.
Sufficient. What do you want to know?
Let me bring up the list of stuff.
Hours some of the seems sands, to do maybe? Stuff. Yeah, I would say either one of the sands or one of the hours abilities. I think we saw gravity well with that big sucking in thing, because it's kind of makes sense.
Yeah, that's true. That makes sense. And it was on the hours, I believe. Or Mire of Time. Would I be able to... Because we're affected by some of the sand right now, correct? Someone is?
Currently, the people affected by I'm sand tainted. Are Zob and Takar.
Could I specifically try and figure out what that one, identify a specific one that they're currently under? Or
you can, and they are the same. They're the same
excellent.
Type
so, yeah,
of sand,
I would like
so.
To do that one.
Okali dokali, neighborino. Sands of Regret, do this. First of all, it's Sands of Regret. At the end of this creature's turn, they must make a DC 21 plus 1 per attack that that character made this turn. If they fail, they take 1 point of exhaustion, and any adjacent allies must make the same save versus this exhaustion.
And what type of save was that? I'm sorry.
That is a... Constitution.
Thank you very much. All right.
We all heal 3 HP, don't we, at the start of your turn? That are within 15 feet?
Yes, the amulet. I think it's just 3 people.
And the bleeding ones heal.
No, 4.
Did the bleeding ones heal from it? Question.
No, most heals don't affect undead constructs.
Bad.
Oh, yeah, and up to 4 creatures. So, yeah, everyone heals for 3 points starting their turn in the aura, and it's 15 feet around me. So, that would be just you at the moment. I think.
That's why I asked. Because I'm selfish.
Yep, so that. Sorry. Apologies. I will get you up some more. No, I think I need to Okay, cool. Action, I will Beacon of Hope. Everyone should be within range.
30 seconds.
Yes, indeed.
20 seconds.
Beacon of Hope for all that, and then I will move. Oops, sorry, my be. Bonus action, I have nothing to do with. 30 feet, move back 10. This way. And that is in turn.
Okay.
Everyone has Beacon of Hope.
All right, start of round. Everybody shift your echoes.
This is going to be painful.
Ah, it's following mine. Oh, no.
It's where you ended your turn at this end of the sort of the thing.
Oh, end of turn. Yes, yes, yes.
Being last sucks.
Yep.
Oh, rip. Yeah.
What is the green triangle for?
Oh, I'm indicating I have Beacon of Hope up.
Oh, I thought it was him putting a debuff.
Yeah, generally speaking, those are those states I use.
Oh, sorry.
So you're gonna confuse people.
I can use any state.
Yeah.
That's fine. I'll
I do something else. Those are bad states.
Ooh, all right.
All right. Let's see here.
I use protection from good.
Starting turn. All right, I will select Tarim. An effect begins to wash over you as doubt begins to fill your mind. You receive no save to this ability, and I cannot tell you why. Tarim, you have disadvantage on all saving throws.
All right.
And close it. And then I will click that, and then I will select Takar. Takar, make me a charisma saving throw.
Man, my favorite skill. This one goes out to all the ladies I've been winking at. I'm sorry.
Oof.
That's a 7. That's the good number. It's a magic special number, right?
No.
Arcadum?
Oh, all right. Damn it. You will move to here.
What's up?
I grant you an attack at advantage against me.
Do I have to take it?
Yes.
Oh. All right.
Of course.
Okay.
Why must you hurt us?
Total damage is?
29 and 1 is 30, plus 11 is 41, 42, because I don't have Hunter's Mark.
Okay. Then, my last bit this time, I will use... Yeah, let's do that. Alright, he will use an ability on himself.
Nobody liked that.
Alright, that's it for that.
Counterspell it.
Takar. It's not a spell.
Alright, cool. Before I do anything, I just want to ask a question. When our echoes are in the same square as us, are we able to physically interact with them?
You could try.
All right. Takar will see that his friend Taram is sad and will give him some words of encouragement. You know, you're not the worst paladin we could have picked. And then he will hit the thing in the face. And miss. And miss. See? You're not the worst.
At least I could hit it.
Yeah. And then he will bonus action disengage and run to here and make a martial check at advantage. So, 16 is probably not good enough.
Insufficient.
Don't worry, guys. I got all the low rolls out of the way. Nice. Let's see. Can I visibly see the sands around me still? Or are they like an effect that's gone away?
The ones on you should still be there. Hold on, let me look.
Okay. Yeah, I think they are, but yeah. I just wanted to double check.
You can see them. Yeah, they're there.
All right, and they're like visible. Are they
visible.
Restricting me in any way, or is it just kind of like?
No, they are a signal that something's affecting you.
Okay, cool. In that case, I will end my turn.
All right, at the end of your turn, make me a DC 21 Constitution saving throw.
Cool. Not death effect.
Oh, hold on, not 20 DC 21. Make it's DC 23.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay.
Every attack.
Yeah, and then is it not a death effect or anything?
Then it is not. Movement.
Okay, cool. So, con save. Nope.
Second level of exhaustion.
Cool.
Alright, on my foods here, so I'll give you a brief time to strategize at the start of Tarim's turn. Be right back.
Okay.
I mean, you're now exhausted too, and your speed is halved, so technically.
My speed is halved?
Yes.
Yeah, that's fine. I have lots of speed. I effectively, I'm just as fast as
regular people.
As regular people.
Okay.
When I use my reactions, I have to do my best to keep his little people in 15 feet of me, otherwise they'll take damage.
Yeah, so I think we did find gravity well with that one ability.
Yeah, makes sense.
I do think that the sands are dispellable. They may not be dispellable. I wonder if you can action remove the sands. That's something I probably should have done instead
well,
of...
Well, yeah, by passing the check.
Yeah, you pass the check, removes the sands. That's what happened to me.
My next round, what I'll probably do is drink a potion of speed, if I have, and that should reduce it down to a 21, which I could potentially, like, beat. I think I have, like, a plus four to my con saves, so it's not super amazing, but I just have to hope I roll high. Yeah, actually, yeah. I may heroism... Well, actually, if I potion of speed, that gives me an haste action, which then I can then use chug another potion with. Oh, wait, no, yeah, I would have to have two item interactions.
Well, could you use your action to... No. You don't have fast hands, do you?
Yeah, I would have to item interaction, pull out the potion of speed, action drink it, then use my second hasted action...
To pull out another one?
Pull out another one.
Yeah.
Because I feel like having... I could haste action, cast Bless on myself. That's, I mean, just as fine. Also, my invulnerability's worn off.
There has to be some way to get its AC down. 26 is...
I mean, honestly, it has the ability to parry with that scythe. I think dispelling the scythe might remove AC as well.
It's,
that's what I plan to do when I hit it.
Yeah. If you can hit it, you can possibly dispelling cord to the scythe.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to T-pose on it. That way so that my echo is T-posing on it.
Yeah, the big reason why I ran up and then ran away is because I want to put a lot of distance between me and my echo every round, since I'm one of the few people that can.
Yeah.
What did he hit Tarm with a despair thing, and it wasn't in sands. That was in his primary second. Oh, that's in seconds that he did it.
Yeah.
So I wonder if that was burden of wisdom. Or the price of progress. Because I don't think we've seen blurring urgency, haste, sitting heights, or reckless speed. I think we've seen burning wisdom or price of progress. We don't know a ton about his hours. When he did the thing where he forced you to attack him, do you remember which initiative phase that was?
I believe it was sands.
Okay, so sands. So that might have been
sands. I had sands around me at the time.
So that might have been sands of war or madness.
Probably sands of madness. More than likely, what he does is he teleports into you, forces you to take an action. That way, it sets off the time bomb, and it also increases the DC that you have to make in order to get past the saving throw for sands.
Since he has combo, my thought is that potentially what he's doing is trying to stack sands on multiple of us and then trigger sandstorm because it triggers more cascading effects.
Oh yeah, there's totally a time bomb like under him now, by the way.
Yeah. Let's see. My guess is that he moved there two rounds ago, so we don't know what the actual timer on time bombs are yet.
Yeah, we need to figure that out.
I roll really bad on my marker.
It's usually one round, is from what I can tell. Because he did 76 last time on the last time bomb, and he didn't speed it up or slow it down.
Yeah. As a note, I'm probably going to back off and drink a potion. Try to get his little people in 15 feet.
Yeah.
Of me as possible.
I'm taking a brief moment to eat real quick.
That's fine.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah.
We're just talking about how we are going to do a conga line. And try to get everyone.
We're going to burst them down to zero in this round, totally, yeah.
Yeah. Man. I do think, though, that Operation Bling Bling is a good idea. Especially if I get if I have the freedom to do it. I think it's worth the risk, guys. There's no dirt, so I can't do the tree strat of planting a tree.
But there is a tree. There's already. There's
yeah, but those trees. Are like special magic trees.
Oh, you need a normal tree, I see.
Also, I don't want to come back to this place, because it seems kind of lame and weird.
Yeah, that's true. It is kind of, it's a bit spooky.
Wait a second. We should probably ask about the scenery. more. Because, like, this clock is, like, destroyed and broken and stuff.
So you're saying is I need to bring out my mason's potter's, like, Smith's tools and fix the clock?
Yes. I want you to mason's tool fix the earth.
All right, yeah.
Or, Simeon, I want you to cast heal clock.
All right. I think I can manage.
Yeah, get mending.
I feel like that's a wizard spell, not a cleric spell.
That's all you need, mending. Mending, yeah. Combined with my work.
Do you have mending as a spell? Or as a cantrip, Simeon?
No.
Who doesn't take mending? That's like not taking prestidigitation.
I like three different flavors of damage cantrips. Thank you very much.
Yikes. I think, though, displaying the scythe is, while important, not super cool. In fact, one can say that when the rhythm of the wind is slow to rise, we must go.
Fifth level spell of flies. And it didn't work. Or I had to roll for it still, so...
What I should totally do is, you know, just start killing the bleeding ones.
You're so mean.
Also, look, almost they're done. About to die. Why don't you do the special fun thing that they do?
Oh, yeah. Guess I should do that.
Yeah.
His con saving throw is garbage.
Yeah, his con saving throw is +7. I mean, the save isn't that high, but he has a chance to fail.
Ones are still fails.
Yeah, ones are still failed.
The issue is to also stop it from healing.
I mean, it has the whole... It has, like, recovery abilities. I think we've maybe seen one of them. With the strip away kind of combo where, hey, guess what? You lose things, then I also heal off of it. So, it's kind of a... I don't know. It's kind of its own thing. But it's something to think about. Who has a better Arcana than Marshall? Or, I like... Do. Maybe make Arcana checks on stuff rather than Martial checks. Sure.
Please same with like
same if you have like religion or something. It might be better.
I actually have a +4 on religion rather than a +2s.
What if you religion the clock?
I don't have religion because Hadron is a known atheist.
Yeah, you know. You're edgy. But
super edgy.
I mean, what's your Martial, Tom?
+2.
Maybe religion the clock.
All right.
I mean, it's worth a shot.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a long shot for me to even pass the marshal, so I mean, something else to do with my reaction. I'm just trying to think of all things I can do that doesn't damage people, because any of my actions fucking can damage everyone within 50 feet.
Uh-oh.
Is it blocking things by dodging it with its armor or with its weapon? Like, how is it AC formatted through RP, and then we can figure out how to deal with everything.
But it's game time, guys.
Tarim. Tarim, yes, start.
I shall move up here. All right.
Go ahead.
Does he use a reaction or anything? All right. I will take the time to drink a... I'll do a potion of invulnerability.
Why is there no tree?
Okay.
That I unfortunately get the tree on myself, but me. HP. And then I will move back down.
Make a religion check.
And I would like to... Can I actually religion check the, like, clock thing here?
You mean the environment?
Yes.
That's fine, go ahead.
All right. That is inaccurate. That macro is broken. It is only a +4.
So 20.
So that's a 21.
With a 21, this is what you're able to... My bad. This is what you're able to determine with a 20. A follower, a cleric, or a paladin in service to Raquel might be able to interact with this environment.
Are there any of those present?
Nope.
Okay.
Mm-mm.
Then the rest of that is pointless.
Good to know. Already concentrating still, so I don't think there's anything else to do with me. I mean, I might as well shove him. Unlikely, but hey, yeah. That's my turn.
Remember not to use actions, you know, if you need to.
Oh, Khalid Dokali.
Sorry.
First, I'll select your invulnerability. I'll use Quicken on that. Quicken it ahead 4 rounds. Yeah. Then, I will place this down. All right, I will then attack Hadron.
Rude.
22.
That'd be -4. I'll transfer half of that. Blood offering.
Okay. Next attack.
That one hits. Let's throw another blood offering on there.
Third attack. Next is ours. All right. That's pretty good. Make me a medicine check because you're right next to him.
For everyone who's next to him?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's check on him, then I have advantage. Still 16.
There you go. Zob, you notice that the creature's wounds are healing from an effect. And now I can actually show you how much was healed, so... I'll go back, damage it, and then I'll re-heal it. It healed that at the start of minutes, and it healed this at the start of hours. Okay. Okay.
Strength saving throws.
I have disadvantage because of an unknown effect, correct?
Yep.
One. Two. I got this.
Aura right now.
Okay. Looks like nobody made it. So, you're all bound there and cannot move. At the start of the next hour's initiative, a massive load of damage will be hitting that place. Oakley Doakley. That's good on that. Tarum, make me an intelligence saving throw.
All right.
Oh no. My brain.
One.
Okay.
That is a 10.
That's not sufficient. Alright, sands start to swirl around you.
What do these sands look like?
They look different than the ones that are currently out.
Okay.
Taking notes.
So we got three people sandy.
Sandy.
Alright, that's set up, sand set up, good. Alright, that's it for me. Switching turns. Zob, turn start.
Marshall check, nope.
Wait, did it not? Hold on. This macro is fucking up. It didn't show you guys the heal. That was at the
43.
Start. Well, yeah, but it didn't show it when I did sands. There you go. I'm not sure why it's not showing you that. All right, anyway, go ahead, Zob.
I'm gonna swing a club at your face. I assume that hits?
Yes, sir.
Okay, make me a wisdom saving throw.
And is that with the plus four for the recent boon?
Yes, it is.
What's this effect against?
Grovel. As the command
spell. Oh, okay.
Whenever I hit you, I cast it for free. Okay, you're fine. And then I'm also going to try dispelling your glaive or scythe, whatever it is.
It's a scythe.
Okay.
Scythe.
Twenty-five.
That is sufficient.
Nice. I don't know what it's gonna do, but it did a thing.
Marshall, check. As soon as you cast the spell.
I already did that. I rolled a one.
No, another one. After you cast the spell. Okay. Something's triggering it.
Is that the 25?
No, that was the dispel.
Okay.
That was my dispel magic.
Another martial job.
All right.
20.
The dilating one is greatly weakened when his spell, when his scythe is dispelled. The dispelling effect lasts for one entire round. That's all initiatives in that round. His defenses and offensive have dropped considerably based around his scythe.
Okay. I'm going to slap a shield of faith on myself.
Okay. Anything else?
No.
Did you have another attack?
I only have one attack.
Yeah.
No.
30 seconds.
I'm 8 cleric for...
Okay.
Fighter, I end my turn.
Okay, turn done. Hadron, turn start.
First things first, martial check. I have advantage. Useless. Second thing, casting dispel magic on the black circle at 4th level. Do I need to roll for it?
For what? Which spell?
Dispel magic, 4th level.
Oh, dispel magic. I thought you said black circle. Okay. Go ahead. Yeah.
One.
21 is sufficient.
Nice. Oh, shit. Bonus action. I'll have my two friends that aren't still affected by metronome attack. Oof. And that'll be my turn.
Switching turns, resetting time. Simeon.
Okay. 22 still in the weakened state, still missed.
No, they hit. Did you guys not see the damage?
No.
God damn it. There's something wrong with this fucking macro. I don't know why it's not doing that.
Hey,
I'll marshal check in the meantime.
There you go.
23 Marshall.
What do you want to know?
And let's see here.
Can you specifically target the thing that's healing him, or do we have to blindly pick that?
He can specifically target that. Yeah.
Figure out the recovery aspect of it.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if we're able to just straight up, hey, something's healing him.
You can do that.
See what it is, or if we have to like.
I was muted. You can do that.
Okay. Cool.
Excellent. Sure, I'd like to identify how his healing works.
Alright, the current healing effect on him is an effect given to him by the ability Reckless Speed. Reckless Speed is you must make a DC 18 Charisma saving throw or be forced to do a charging attack. The Dio gains fast healing equal to the damage that attack did, and it lasts for 3 rounds.
Well,
that heals him at the beginning of each of his initiatives.
Oh, I'm sorry, guys.
It lasts 3 rounds?
Yep.
Okay, excellent. Action, I will drink a potion of heroism. And then bonus action, I will cast Healing Word on Hadron at the 2nd level. Hopefully this isn't broken. And due to Beacon of Hope that is active, he heals for 44 HP.
And goes up to 47.
Bonus action, action, martial, movement. I think I want to. Oh, I want to move away from my guy. If that does anything, really. Before I move, let me check this. Okay, I still have 2 minutes. Yeah. I'll move. Oops, that was my little dude. Yep, I'll move right here. And end turn.
Turn done.
Yes, sir.
All right. Resetting time.
Echoes move back to people.
All echoes reset.
So is this echoes just on my ass the entire time?
Well, it's where you were at the end of your turn last turn. So it's always one round in between you.
Oh, okay, so I ended my turn right here, so it is there?
Yeah, because that's where you were last round.
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah, there's one round of stagger between each of you. So you got to kind of remember that.
Okay, gotcha. Yeah, I must have mixed it up last round. Thank
it's
you.
All good. It's all good. There's a lot going on, so I don't blame you. Well, my scythe is disabled. I don't like that one little bit at all. Oh, y'all some poo-poo heads.
And yeah, I gained that healing.
I remember your glue.
Fine then. Let's stop pillow fighting. The dilating one will raise its hands above its head, and it will call forth to the energies that surround it. The dilating one will activate a violet ability.
Oh no.
And expend one entropy to do so. Who's it gonna be?
I just healed him.
Let's do that. Yes. Okay. I will select Tarum.
Sir?
Tarum, make me 3 saving throws of your choice.
Flip. Check. Bet.
What'd you say?
I was just checking which one would be my best. So we're going to go with strength saving throws. I'm going to put on some naughty farmer to help me here.
All right.
All right. Let's see. Throw 1. Disadvantage due to... That's unfortunate.
1 fail.
14. Saving save 2. Oh, that is
that's
unfortunate.
No matter what else you roll. That's 2 fails.
Yep.
Last one.
Yep.
God damn.
3 fails. Unfortunate. All right. Tarum, choose an arm.
Let's do my left.
Left arm? All right. You don't have a left arm anymore. What was in it?
That would be my, probably my shield.
Your shield is also destroyed.
I just finished that.
You just finished All right. making it.
The dilating one will grasp at your arm and will turn it to ash as violet light pierces out from its hand. Your arm is destroyed, and the shield attached to it is as well. In addition to that, take 43 bleed damage at the start of each of your turns. Healing will only have that.
Ooh.
Okay.
Yeah, I doubt.
Suffer! Okay. And then I will.
I just want to let you know, I doubt has any effect, but I want to let you know that was a series item to glory.
That is unfortunate. All right. What food buffs do you guys have right now?
Temp HP. Well, would you rather we just post them?
It's fine. I'm not going to waste it on that. I'll just remove that another way. Okay, let's do that instead.
Don't worry, Tarim. We know a guy who can get you an arm back. He's a fish.
All right. Do you still have a vulnerability potion active, Simeon?
Yes, I do.
Not anymore.
Oh, no.
Takar.
Alrighty, then. I will item interaction, grab a potion from my bandolier. Action, chug a potion down. I am now hasted. I will then use my double speed to run to, like, here. And then I would like to ask you a few questions.
Yep.
First and foremost, I can still see my mini-me, or my Echo.
Yep.
Are the sands on my Echo as well?
No.
Cool. Second question. The boss, did it actually just speak in, like, a language that we can understand?
Yes.
Cool. That is good to know. Let's see. What else? I will make a martial check.
Tarim staggers around, his arm missing, but he still holds strong. What's the weapon in your other hand, Tarim?
That is finisher spike.
Is it a one-handed or two-handed weapon?
It is a one-handed.
Sick.
That is a 30 martial on the boss.
What do you want to know?
Big money.
I would like to know. I would like to know what.
That is enough to know, and also advice on what ability you should identify.
All right, cool. Hey, can you give me some advice on an ability I should try to identify?
Yes. You need to identify all of the sands. You need to know what they do.
All right. Can I identify sands of war then?
Sir. All right. Sands of war is a DC 20 charisma saving throw. Once it's affected, somebody at the end of their turn, they must make the save again if they are adjacent to the dilating one. If they fail, on their next turn, they must attack the dilating one with an attack and cannot move.
Okay, cool. So that was the one that Hadron had on him for a second. Alrighty then. And then I would like to... I still have my haste action. So I would like to haste action... So I'm carrying 150 pounds of coal. I would like to haste action dump coal on the ground. How much can I dump in an action?
Well, what are they in?
It's just in sacks.
You have 150 pounds of... Okay.
I'm a Goliath.
That doesn't matter. It's purely like... What else do you have? Because 150 pounds of coal, while you are a Goliath and can carry it, That would put you offset of balance. Like, that would be huge. 150 pounds of coal would be, like width-wise, would be bigger than you are.
I mean, I have it on me.
If it's just a sack, then pouring it out is going to take several rounds.
Okay, like, I don't want to pour it all out. I just want to pour some out.
All right, that's fine, I guess.
Cool. All right, I pour coal on the ground, and in my turn, and I guess make a constitution saving throw for the sand.
Mm-hmm.
I guess it's DC 21 because I didn't make an attack, so.
Correct.
See if I can finally pass this. Ah, dang it, so close.
That is really bad. That's your third level of exhaustion.
Do you have Bless, or do you have the D4 from...
I have the reroll failed saving throw, advantage on death saves. It's fine, though. I have speed, and I have advantage, so now I'm just attacking at normal, so it should be fine.
All right, then. That it for you?
That'll be it for me.
Tarm. Turn start. If you're talking, I can't hear you.
Oh, sorry. I took the bleed damage, and then I said,
"You may know the pain of suffering, but my time is not yet,"
as he goes to attack.
Sick.
That is a crit.
Nice RP crit, bro.
Hell yeah. All right, double smite that.
Double smite.
Level smite it.
Just give me the...
Actually, yeah.
Give me the total damage. Smite.
I would use my shield ability if I still had it.
Pepe hands.
It is 88.
Totals how much?
Let's see, 24, 2, 26, 38, 39. It is 77 damage.
77 damage, you say?
Hey, that's the double special number.
Hell yeah! And I'm Nitro 77. Boom! Alright. And then...
Flex his sight this down.
And I can't parry it, so... Yep, alright. I'll just eat that shit sandwich.
Attack again. Probably missed that time. 18 hit?
18 does hit.
Okay.
Goodness.
That is 28 damage. Yeah. HP. And unfortunately, that shouldn't stop. Gain 10 for temp HP as well.
Alright, that it for you?
Yes, that will be all. I had Marshall.
All right, and that, gentlemen, is where we will have to call it, because it is 2 a.m.
All right, Captain.
Thank you for running the game for us.
Yeah, thank you. It's been fun.
Sorry, I'm so exhausted. I'd beat you RPing more, but I am fucking...
Nah, this is our late night hours. We're all cool, play some smooth jazz.
Bro. It's 11 a.m. for me, so it's not late night for me.
Kicking all of the ass. That was good shit. I took a man's arm. Fuck, dude.
Oh, my arm! I'm actually more upset about losing the shield than I am my arm. If I'm
yeah, the shield arm. That you just finished
I finished it yesterday.
I'm sorry, yep. Sir. Sometimes it really be like that.
Yeah, but hey, I'm still alive. We're all alive. That's all I can ask for.
And it's time for fan art.
You have to die in order to get fan art, though. Also, I've been keeping track of DKP, guys. Ugh, it's not looking good for y'all.
You know, I gotta be honest. The DKP chart kind of rigged.
What? That's minus DKP
I said nothing. Don't know what you're talking about.
As raid leader, I will keep an eye on you.
Forgive me, but I'll have to go out all out just this once, okay? Good luck, everyone.
You're lucky I'm not counting your temp HP healing as healing.
Kono Dioda.
Also, right now the boss is winning with negative 200 DKP, so we need to really step our game up.
Whoa.
Oh, that is awesome, right?
Yeah.
That one's really cool. I like that one a lot. More Dio. Take this, Dio! 20 meter radius fireball! I like that.
I'm surprised Hadron's cast spells. He doesn't usually cast spells.
Actually casting
spells. There's magic. Fucking magic, dude.
That looks cool. I like that one.
Oh my god.
That one's sick.
Nice.
Magic.
It's big old scythe.
Oh man. Dude. Dude, this is so sick. Look at this one.
Yeah.
Fuck, it had to do it, dude. Huffburn Grave. Oh my god, that's so good, man.
Oh my god.
He's crying.
Oh, that one's sick.
Don't worry, guys. Goodness. If anything, it's better if I get 5 exhaustion really fast, because then you could just bring me back to life.
Oh, look. It has boobies. All right.
Poggy woggy.
I prefer this version of Dio.
Didn't get too much sleep, but I got a few hours of anxiety. And
accurate.
Who tries to end Verum at 3 a.m.? Oh, boy, 3 a.m.
Boy.
Pepe hand. No.
We can find the person who made Coop's art, and they can make your art too. The emote with the dragonborn with one hand.
It's not even one hand, it's one arm.
Yeah.
Ooh.
That one has
Dioda. Pepe hand.
Pepe hand. No! Oh, I love that.
My arm.
There it is.
Pepe hand.
I'm sorta all right.
Emote.
Poor Taro.
Yep. Sort of all right. You know.
Hey, you know it's okay. We can get you a new one.
Like I said, I need to go find an arms dealer.
Yeah, I got money like that. I can.
Yeah.
If you like make me feel bad enough, I might do something to help you.
Alrighty, save that. Thanks for all the fan art, guys. I must now finally rest, because I have been going hard all day long. Thanks again to the brave heroes of Kalkatesh that signed up and are fighting for their lives on behalf of all others. I'll see you guys next week. Farewell.